We have been focusing on the risk and protective factors for substance use, and that includes tobacco, marijuana, and other illicit drugs. More recently, we have been doing a number of longitudinal studies so that we can look at the consequences of substance use on functioning, covering a whole variety of areas: physical functioning, intellectual functioning, social functioning, emotional, and other assuming adult roles. With regard to the consequences of marijuana, we have found that it leads to or is associated with later impaired health, and that's marijuana over time. It is also associated with antisocial personality disorder, depressive disorders, anxiety disorders, health problems, and as well as adult functioning in general. If a parent uses marijuana, chronically, it is associated with interference with the attachment relationship as well as establishing rules. That in turn has an impact on the youngster's personality, which in turn is related to who they select for peers. That in turn has an effect on their own drug use, which is then transmitted to their children. And it's important to look at not just one risk factor at a time, but multiple risk factors as it relates to substance use and marijuana.
We're particularly interested in looking at the transgenerational transmission of risk factors for marijuana use, but other factors as well, including other substance use, antisocial behavior, and the way that, for instance, externalizing behavior is transmitted across generations. And our feeling is that early interventions and early identification and early interventions are the way to break the chain of transmission over many generations.